If you picked up your Android phone right now, one thing will be very obvious to you. The proximity sensor is quite simply the most visible sensor on any phone. While some phones do a better job of hiding it into the bezel, for what it's worth, it's pretty visible nonetheless. But it's not the only sensor on a smartphone. As it turns out, these things come packed with a number of sensors, which makes me wonder, what exactly are they there for? What's up guys, I'm Akshay from Beebom.com and in this video we'll talk about the sensors on an Android device. So without further ado, let's jump right in. Before we dive into the video though, you might want to check what all sensors your phone has using this app called Sensor Box for Android, the link to which you can find in the description below. Taking a look at the proximity sensor first, it basically detects when something gets close enough to the front of your Android device. How it works is by emitting an IR beam and detecting changes in the return signal. It is commonly only used to turn the screen off when you answer a call, to save battery life and to prevent accidental screen touches from your cheek. But there have been some really imaginative uses of this sensor. For example, there's an app called Wave Control that uses the proximity sensor to allow you to control media playback on your phone. You'll look really cool using this, I'm sure. Another really great use of the proximity sensor is made by Kinscreen, which allows you to lock and wake up your phone simply by using the proximity sensor to judge when it is in your pocket and when it's not. The magnetometer is one sensor that most of us probably don't ever realize exists in our phones. That's probably because it's not as prominent as the proximity sensor and its applications are not as widely used or observed either. But it is capable of detecting the magnetic field around the phone, detect changes in the field, and even quantify the intensity of the magnetic field near the device. One great use of the magnetometer is made by Google Cardboard. You must have noticed that flicking the magnet on the cardboard acts as a trigger for clicking on things in virtual reality. Ever wondered how that works? Well, it is the magnetometer. It detects a change in the magnetic field and gets the app to trigger a function accordingly. The accelerometer measures and keeps a track of the orientation of the device. For example, take a look at this app called Pocket Bubble Level. The app uses the accelerometer to figure out the orientation of the device. You can see, when we tilt the phone, the bubble level responds accordingly. However, it does not measure the rotation. We'll come to that part later. One great use of the accelerometer has been made in Android 7.1, where you can simply raise your device to wake the screen. This is also a feature in the new iOS 10. Since this is sensor dependent, you can actually get this feature on older phones as well. There's an app called Smart Wake, which basically gives you raise to wake functionality on a phone running an older version of Android as well. It's really cool and the feature itself is quite handy. Coming to the rotation part now, the gyroscope is the sensor that keeps a track of how the device is being rotated. For example, if the phone is kept upright and rotated, the accelerometer will not notice any change because the phone is still in the same orientation. However, the gyroscope will be able to know that the phone is rotated and to what extent. This property of a gyroscope is what's used in VR apps such as Google Cardboard and even in those 360-degree videos on YouTube. There are a lot of great VR games that have been made possible thanks to the gyroscope. One such game is Cyclops Duck Hunt. This is a weird, albeit fun reimagination of the classic NES game Duck Hunt. You should definitely check it out. The camera itself is a sensor, so yes, we are going to include that as well. The basic use of a camera sensor is to detect light and to use that to click a picture. But it can also be used in various other applications such as detecting motion. One app that does this and does it well is Motion Detector Pro. So if you have some old Android phones lying around in your house, you can use this app to turn your phone into a rudimentary security camera. The app works by using the camera feed to detect motion, and when it does, it clicks a picture and sends it to your email address. Obviously, this can't replace a proper security system, and I wouldn't recommend you do that anyway, but it may be a fun way to repurpose your old Android device and keep a track of who comes inside your room while you're out. There are some more sensors on Android devices, and they are pretty self-explanatory, so I'm just summing them up here. The light sensor is a sensor that is responsible for measuring the intensity of light falling on the device. Devices use this to control the automatic brightness. The temperature sensor can sense the temperature around the Android device and can be used to make apps that make your phone show the temperature of the room, etc. The barometer is a sensor that measures the air pressure being exerted on the device. There are apps that use this data to figure out the altitude at which the phone is placed.
Well, those were the sensors you can find on Android devices. I hope this video helped you learn something more about them, and if it did, make sure you hit that like button. Also, subscribe to our channel for more cool tech videos, and until next time, thanks for watching.